back in ripping off food.
Well, you
gotta and, like I said, I give compliments to the food and the hospitality that's been extended to me and my club members, especially my president.
Most definitely. Thank you guys for coming to talk to
Chocolate
with us for a little bit. And y'all can go back and have some more food.
Thank you.
Peace.
All right,
you guys, we are here with some customers. So tell us, this is your first time,
you said.
So how do you feel about the vibe?
Oh, I love it. Like, when I walked in, I was like, this is amazing. This is really nice. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's straight.
It really is. I like the vibe. I like how it's not too many people, just enough. And you said you're about to try some food, right?
Yeah. This is going to be my first time.
Have you heard about the egg rolls? It's just the food and egg rolls. It's really fine.
Well, first, I'm starting off with one lemon pepper wings.
Oh, then, okay. You can never go wrong with wings. Exactly. You can never go wrong. If you mess up on some wings, then you're doing something wrong. But I can't say you do egg rolls. I just asked. All right. What about you?
Nah, I can't since they've been open.
Oh, you have? So you like the vibe and everything?
Yeah, it's cool to vibe. Okay. I've been here every week.
Oh, every week? Oh, okay, so you be out here.
Yeah, I'm here every week. So yeah, it's cool to vibe.
Most definitely. How do you like the food and stuff like that?
Boudin egg rolls good. The pork chops good.
Pork chops is good.
The Cajun pasta good. What else I have? The fries. He can do the wings a little bit spicy. Me and him talked about that already. He needs to make a little bit more spicy.
Oh, okay, you like the spicy
stuff. Yeah. So everything else though, it's cool. Okay. You know what I'm saying? Price is good, the shots good. They got $3 shots. Sometimes you can get it for $2. Just depends on how many you drink. Don't tell them I told y'all. Matter of fact, cut this.
Now the egg roll, now we gotta catch the egg roll, right?
Yeah, you gotta taste the egg roll. What's the first two songs?
Okay. This the egg roll. Let me see. Since you talked all that, you put your life on it.
I talked a lot.
All right, let me see. Oh yeah, you prayed with you made sure you involved Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit. And God the Father. And this is what you call the Trinity. You got some pork chops, you got an egg roll and a fried biscuit. You wanna pray? Dear Heavenly Father. Thank you for this gift. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
I mean, obviously the food is smack. So make sure you guys come out and enjoy the party with the rest of the people. Thank you, Mr. Ben.
Thank you.
And there you have it, you guys. We are here at Bar 725. And as you can see, this food is amazing. He did his thing. And we just thank God for this wonderful food in front of me. Amen.
Putting it on my chain, when it rides.
Welcome to the Not So Christian to Me show. I'm your host, Southern Girl Denise, and today's show is all about phenomenal black women. Women who broke down barriers to create and cultivate their own lane. They are independent, fierce, and strong.
Now walk us through the transition to becoming a successful black woman.
The transition for me was that last time I was in prison and I wanted something different, and I seen other people and other black women on television and just in life living life and doing things differently. And I'm saying, I'm no different from them. Why can't I, you know, be successful in any kind of way? So success is measured by different levels. So success for me was that first year, just being able to get off parole. That was my first successful, you know, attempt of being successful. And then it was, oh, let me start school at 39 years old, at, you know, with an AA degree. And then each step I became more successful, from an AA degree to a bachelor's degree to a master's degree to, you know, becoming an author. And now, you know, finishing up my last year in my PhD program.
Well, tell us about what you're doing.
So I have my own podcast, and I'm also involved in a mentorship with the organization back at home called the Naked Foundation. And I feel like I could be a light. Well, everybody could be a light, you know, but I try to give back as much as possible, because I don't want to feel like I'm selfish with sitting on so much experience or knowledge. So that's just a little bit. I mean, it's crazy how it, just being in different circles, you run across so many different people that can give you an opportunity to do different things.
Greetings and salutations. This your man, Gifted the Flamethrower, New Orleans named the son, Houston's adopted son. And right now, I'm getting ready to be live on the Not So Christian in Me show. We're going to be discussing a lot of things, whatever comes on the table. Make sure you check out my new album, Authentic, live now everywhere.
Welcome to the Not So Christian to Me show. I'm your host, Southern Girl Denise, and today's show is all about artists on the rise during this pandemic. And today I have the handsome Gifted.
Hey.
What's going on, Gifted?
What's up, ma'am? How are you?
Man, I'm doing good.
You look
good.
Beautiful. Thank I love you, the hair. I love the purple.
Thank
Come
you.
Through the knees.
I know. You know, it's been a minute since I've seen
it's
you.
It's been a minute, man, since the Blessed Beat Studios.
I know.
I
just want to thank you for that video that you shared when you tagged me on it. It was a song that you had on Instagram.
Oh.
And I was like, what? You tagged
right?
me? That was
my girl, man.
I like that. Thank you so much. Yeah. I really appreciate
you inspired that. Me. Now,
I was just getting ready to say, what inspired you to do that?
Man, music is, I can be watching a television show, I can see something outside, God may give me an idea, creativity just comes.
It
doesn't come from just one element. I try to keep myself open to everything and try to spew it out as I can
bring
it. And then I just make it rhyme at the end. So we took all that music,
Threw
that music in the dumpster, walked away from the deal, and been running with God ever since. Matter of fact, Zeta's getting ready to drop a project right now called Freedom of Speech. So even she's still rocking and rolling. My brother, he's a pastor. He has a church here in Houston, Bound for Glory. So everybody's still rolling.
That is a huge testimony, and I never knew that.
Hello there. My name is Tree G Music. You can follow me on all social media at just that, Tree G Music. I'm excited to be here today at the Not So Christian in Me show. Thank you for having me. We're going to talk about the collaboration between myself, True Jesus, and the clothing line, Ottawa Clothing. I'm very excited to be here. I hope my hair looks all right. I'm out here with orange britches on, okay? So I'm trying to make this personality come over to you through this mask, okay? Because it's hard to breathe, but we're breathing out here. Thank you for being who you are. Tune in. It'll be coming to you soon.
Rome wasn't built in one day, so the heart of gold to match your soul is worth the wait.
What's up, you guys? You guys are tuning into the Not So Christian to Me show, and I'm your host, Southern Girl Denise, and today's show is all about artists on the rise during the pandemic. And today we have a very special guest, the lovely Miss Tree G here. How you doing, girl?
I'm doing well.
She's just all glamorous, can't you see?
Thank you so much.
She's glowing. What's going on, girl?
Everything and nothing at all at the same time.
I'm going to just jump on in and talk about your bio, because when I heard about your own day in Austin,
yes,
wow, Tree G, what did, wait a minute, let me make sure I say this right.
Okay.
Hashtag Tree G Music Day in Austin.
Yes, ma'am.
Tell me all about that.
Okay, so first of all, for those of you out there who don't know where Austin is, Austin is the state capital of my home state, which is Texas.
Okay.
I just thought I'd pause there, right there, with the, you know, that X in the middle. Texas! Okay, I'm just kidding. So very grateful space that I'm in right now because of the, that's a big thing, you know, to receive that. I feel so honored.
Yeah.
And I was in Austin and am in Austin. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm all around Texas, you know.
Yeah.
For 13 years consecutively, just sharing my talent of singing, my gift of voice. And when I say gift, not only because it's something that sounds nice, but it's also something that allows communication in a different way, you know. And I'm grateful for those that I've gotten to meet along this journey, and now I'm grateful for meeting you.
Yes, it is an honor to meet you, you know. We kind of like have mutual friends.
Yes, ma'am.
And, you know, when you were brought to my attention, I'm like, perfect, perfect. She's glowing, you know, she's stunning, you know, you have a great career.
Thank you.
When I heard your story over the phone about everything that you've been doing, I'm like, oh,
yes,
I have to have on my show.
Well, come on, because I'm here.
Yeah.
I got this drink in my cup. So good. I got this drink in my cup.
I came down with hold up. I say hold up. I done came down like hold up. Shit.
Everyone, it's Erin Holmes with the Not So Christian and Me Show, and we have Roderick here, and we also have Marquise, who are the founders of Legendaire Peach Tea Rum, okay? And we are at the wine tasting. And I did want to ask you guys, what made you guys, what inspired you guys to get into the liquor business?
I was trying to do my homework, and he distracted me with liquor and the rest of it. No, I was playing.
the truth of the matter is this. What happened is, back when I was in the music industry, I was inspired to try to think of creative ways to make more money.
Okay.
And so I did come up with an idea to go into the liquor and steal spirits. So after a while, after I came up with the product, I pulled in Marquise.
Okay.
I pulled in our other business partner that is not here, Michael. And so after a while, we came up with Legendaire Peach Tea Rum. And by the way, this is very smooth, goes down easy, no aftertaste, no hangovers. This is the best product that you're going to get on the market. I can assure you that.
Yes, yep. I am super excited to be trying the peach tea rum, okay?
Thank you. I am Tammy Durden, the image maker, owner of Tammy Durden International, and your health and wellness advocate. I'm so super excited to be here on today on the Not So Christian In Me show. Stay tuned.
How you guys doing? I'm Brian Wilturner, the creator of The Pocket. I want to thank the Not So Christian In Me show for allowing me to come share my product with you guys. Hopefully you guys just give it a shot. Go to thepocketusa.com or go to any one of my social media platforms. Instagram, Brian Wilturner. Facebook, Brian Wilturner. Thank you.
Hello, hello. You guys are tuned into the Not So Christian In Me show. I'm your host, Southern Girl Denise, and today's show is all about entrepreneurs. I love today's show because I'm an entrepreneur, and I have two entrepreneurs here today. They're going to talk about their product, but before we talk about their product, I want you guys to see it for yourself. Take a look.
Hi, I'm Tammy Durden, the image maker and your health and wellness advocate. I'm so super excited to be partnering with a wellness company, Tava, that offers amazing all-natural products that facilitates the weight loss and wellness process. We have the Vasea Detox Tea that detoxes your body. We also have the Valley 30 Liquid Vitamin that replenishes while you detox. And then there's the Flair Energy Booster that gives you energy and burns fat. Last but not least is the Caprice Deluxe Coffee infused with CBD. Guess what? No more anxiety, no more chronic pain. These products are amazing and get results. For more information, go to my website, tdurton.tavalifestyle.com.
A simple traffic stop can take a turn for the worse. Due to our anxiety or just the fear of the police officers, there is no need to panic or reach. I introduce to you The Pocket. This product is for our safety and the officer's comfort. As you get pulled over, have your license and insurance inserted in the pocket. Place it on the outside of the door. As the officer walking up, he will visibly see the pocket on the door with your license and insurance, and will also see your hands visibly on the steering wheel. The pocket will also help with social distancing due to COVID-19. The officer will take the pocket to his car, run your license, and return the pocket to your door. He will insert your citation, if there is one, and both parties will drive away safely. My message to you, survive the encounter with the police officer. Get home. The pocket for our safety and the officer comfort.
Yo, what's up, y'all? It's your boy, Adrian B. I'm a guest on the Not So Christian In Me show today, and I want to thank y'all for having me. Bam.
I hope you're ready. I'm coming over to your place tonight. That keep you up, no snoring.
What's up, what's up? It's Southern Girl Denise, the host of the Not So Christian In Me show. And guess what? Today we have a Houston R&B artist who's blowing up on social media. I mean, like, every time I look up on social media, here you go, posing and stuff with another person with him and stuff. I was like, okay, I see it. He fly. Without further ado, help me welcome R&B artist Adrian B. Man, every time I look up on social media, I see you posing,
man,
doing something.
I'm trying.
What keeps you going? I mean, you know.
Man, I feel like I'm behind. Yeah. So I feel like I got a lot of catching up to do.
Okay.
So I'm just on the grind, man, trying to, you know, catch up with the rest, you feel me?
Well, catch us up to what's going on with you, and for those who don't know about you, tell us a little bit about you.
Born and raised here in Houston. From Maker's Home, Fofo, whatever.
Fofo.
Yeah. North Plaza. Let's get it. But yeah, man, on the north side of Houston, man. My mom is a music teacher.
I didn't know that.
Made, yeah. She's Dr. Rose Brunswick. Mm. She has her doctorate
so
in
music. So it runs in the family.
Yes. She's taught not only myself. She's taught a lot of other artists out here in Houston that you guys all know. You know, I'm not gonna name drop, but I'm pretty cool. You know what I'm saying?
They Googling right now. Like, yeah. Mother.
So yeah, man. North side of Houston, man. Grew up, started out in church behind her, and I was playing drums. And
okay.
I wasn't really singing. wasn't really interested in singing. Then I stumbled over a basketball, and that was the end of music. You know, yeah. So like coming through high school, man, I was a basketball player. I was pretty good. Stayed in the paper then too.
Okay.
You know?
Okay.
Yeah, I was pretty good. But then that didn't work out, and I turned back to the old music, man. And here we go. You know. So.
Why did you do music instead of doing other stuff?
Cause it came natural. It came natural, even though I kind of pushed it to the side. It still was something when I got with groups of people. It was something that when I would open my mouth and maybe sing a little something with some people, wow, yeah, you know. Yeah. So it was like it was something that I was like, I gotta take a stab at it, you know what I mean? So.
Do you remember your first song?
My first, no. I came up in a family that I was singing since before I probably remember. I don't even remember what the first song was. Yeah.
And so when you started singing and stuff, like, did you like write stuff down and then later go back to it to make a song? Walk us through that creative process.
Man, my creative process is very, very different than most. Mm-hmm. It's very, it's definitely organic.
Okay.
And it's one of a kind. Because I don't write anything down. Mm-hmm. People see that I write a lot of songs and like, man, you're writing like all the time. Like, yeah, I write probably 2 or 3 songs a day. But I don't write any of that down. It's kind of a marriage to the music thing. If I can't remember the lyrics, it's not a hit. That's just how I feel. So if I read it today and tomorrow I can't remember it when I turn the music back on, it's not a hit. So I'm gonna change it.
Yeah, it's lit. I've been blessed up. I've been broke down. Gotta catch up. Gotta shine now. Running faster. I can't slow down. Gotta catch up. Gotta shine now. Cause I've been blessed up.